So when you won in your second time in 2005, how did you prepare for the pageant in Bangkok? What were the preparations?
After I won Miss Canada?
Yes, yes.
My preparations were quite dedicated. I was preparing with everything that I had. I, of course, had my national director and my trainer. So Dennis Davila, he's the national director of Miss Canada. And he helped me a lot to prepare an interview and how to speak well. And how to, of course, he helped me prepare all my outfits and my evening gown. Mm-hmm. And I had another trainer, Miguel Martinez, who was my coach for runway and also for styling and a lot of those things, that stage presentation. So I was preparing every single day. I would be watching past Miss Universe pageant tapes. We actually had VCRs back then.
VCR. Remember?
Yeah, I would put in a tape of all my favorite Miss Universe pageants, and I would watch the recordings over and over again. So I just felt like I was absorbing a lot of the winner's frequency, you know? I would tune in to the girls who really did well in pageants, and they radiated that winner's vibe, I suppose. Yes. And I would just sit there and watch.
Who were those Miss Universe that you were checking out during
this
time?
Of course, there was Oksana Fedorova, Amelia Vega, Jennifer Hawkins, all the girls who came before me. I didn't watch so many pageants of the past before 2000s. I think I started from maybe like Puerto Rico, Denise Quiñones, and then onwards.
Yeah, the 2000s, the 21st century.
Yeah.
The start of the 21st century Miss Universe.
Because actually, it was really hard to get tapes of previous pageants. It was very difficult.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to watch them. I just couldn't get my hands on them. So I would watch whatever I recorded myself from the TV at that time.
That's true. And plus, the system of judging was almost the same since the time of Denise Quiñones, I think. Like, wherein they would just announce the fourth runner-up, third runner-up, and the second runner-up. Because prior to that, it was top six and then top three. And then they announced the winner. But during your time, it was already top five. And they reverted back into the top. Yeah, they reverted back into the top five system in 2001 during the time of Denise Quiñones.
Ah, I see. Wow, you're a real pageant historian, aren't you?
Well, yeah, Kim Yi in year 2000.
Yeah.
She was the last Canadian to be in the top five before you.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's right. Yeah.
That was it. And then came Natalie. Finally.
That's right. I'm hoping that soon there's gonna be another Canadian who takes over that title of being a third Canadian to win. I'm actually training a lot of girls right now for Miss Canada. Mm-hmm. Miss World Canada, Miss Universe Canada, and some of the other local pageants in Canada. So mm-hmm. I'm really hoping that one of my students is going to win this year so she can shine on the universe. And
yeah.
Let's see. There's a couple of girls who I really feel could do well at Miss Universe.
When you train girls for Miss Universe Canada, that means you're also training someone who will go to Miss International, because one of the girls, one of the runners-up always goes to Miss International anyway. So
that's
who knows?
True.
You might win Miss International as well.
That would be amazing. I feel like all of my girls who I train, they're like my little daughters, and I'm so proud to see them succeed. It's incredible.